May ang question, how does one use point therapy? One point therapy. So, the ideal way to use it is to first treat the pain locally or acupoint and energetically. So, sometimes you will use needles or cupping or electrical stimulation, etc. So, after removing the local needles, when the patient has no more needles on the body, then make the patient sit or lie comfortably before using your single needle. Okay, remember po. So, the one-point needle should be placed on the affected side. For pain in the left leg, place needle on the left arm. Okay, and vibrated as constantly as possible with pulses lasting a few seconds while the patient moves the affected limb very slowly. Okay, you can control the pain relief by asking the patient how severe the pain. So, yung gauge niya ay 1 to 10. Tatanungin niyo yung patient. The maximum drop in pain will be in the first half minute. Then the pain will continue to diminish slowly over the next 2 minutes. Okay. You can then remove the one needle. Okay. This treatment could be done each time the patient comes at the end of the session. Okay. It works best in pains of an excessive nature, yung yin excess or yang excess. Okay. After each session, the patient will feel greatly improved, but some of the pain will return. 5 to 6 sessions of one-point therapy would be enough. And then the pain should be treated with some tonification of the opposite polarity. For instance, if you have been sedating the yang of the large intestine meridian a few times, you should then do some yin tonification to finish off. Okay? One-point therapy works on the principle of the superficial energy circulation. Sedation of one point sedates the energy in the meridian of the sedated point and in the meridian of its same polarity in the arm or leg or in the meridian in front of it in the organ clock. So, okay, alam nyo dapat yung ano yung organ clock. For instance, say you have a backache of the excess nature because of trying to lift weight or because of a sports injury. This pain of the urinary bladder meridian would respond to sedation of SI7. But if the head if the backache started suddenly after exposure to cold, this would only respond to kidney 5 sedation. Okay. In this relationship, a yang excess in the urinary bladder can be sedated in 2 ways besides direct sedation on the meridian. One, sedate the small intestine meridian, yung arm meridian, the same polarity. Okay. Number 2, sedate the kidney meridian. It is the meridian in front of the organ clock, which could block it and cause an excess. So sedating it will unblock flow on the superficial energy circulation. You can screenshot po para ma-remember nyo. Or a blocked nose could be treated with 1 sedation of LI4 and would respond if it was because of an allergy, which is yang cause. Okay. Number 2, sedation of the spleen 5, the same polarity leg meridian, if it is was due to excessive dampness, which is a yin cause. Okay? So, every meridian has 2 possibilities of sedation other than direct sedation on its own meridian. However, this is not true in the case of 3 meridians, yung large intestine, small intestine, and triple warmer. This is because their same polarity meridians and the meridians before them are the same. Therefore, pains along large intestine meridian can only be treated with sedation of the stomach meridian. Remember po, pains along the small intestine meridian are treated with sedation of the bladder meridian. And pains along the triple warmer meridian are treated with sedation of the gallbladder meridian.